Hello, and welcome back to another video on this channel. This is my Sony ZV-E10. Recently the kit lens got a small hit and now it makes these noises whenever it zooms in and out. Of course, it does its job still fine, but I wanted to upgrade to some better glass anyways. Because of that, I thought this was maybe a good idea to try and figure out how working with a prime lens actually affects my workflow, since I never used one before and real lenses are really expensive. In a complete contrast to that, my goal will be to build this one without buying anything, true DIY style. So today I'm gonna be building what is called a dispo lens. Basically, you take the lens from a disposable camera and put it in a custom body so it can be attached to your digital camera. Most dispo lenses are fixed focus, but I found this awesome model on printables.com by a guy named Volzotan, which includes a separate focus ring. By turning it, it changes the distance of the lens from the camera sensor, giving me the ability to focus. He was also kind enough to explain everything in a blog post or, if that's not for you, a video. Okay, everything's going great so far. Now onto the parts. A classmate of mine still had an unused disposable camera, which he was kind enough to give me. Now you might recognize that this camera looks a little bit different from the one used by Volzotan, but I'm sure it's nothing, it'll work out. I removed the stickers on the outside and with the help of a screwdriver I was able to pry my way into the case. While I was at it, I also decided to disassemble all of the other mechanisms for loading the film as well as the shutter. It's actually quite interesting how the spring for the shutter gets loaded when you load the next frame on the film. Also, I'm definitely keeping this viewfinder. I had tested the flash before, but even though it didn't work and I had removed the battery, I still was careful not to touch any of the electronics since the capacitor could still have a small charge. And what a surprise, when I tried to charge it with my screwdriver, there was a small spark. After some more disassembling, I got the lens out. It's literally just a small piece of plastic that looks like it has a dent inside. In regards to the lens body, my physics teacher was kind enough to let me use the new 3D printer of my school, and when we found that they didn't have any black PLA, he even took the STL files home and printed them on his private printer. I'm gonna put a link to his makerworld.com profile in the description, on which he posts some fun puzzles. The parts were printed with a 0.4mm nozzle, a 0.12mm layer thickness, and 80% infill. When he gave them to me, I was really shocked by the quality. There were no printing lines visible and he used a grainy brace plate for some of the parts, which gave them this really nice surface. This also means that I got some parts two times and can decide which finish I want. Assembly was really easy. Basically, you just slot the lens into the hole on the focus ring and then clamp it by spring on the aperture. The base for the bayonet mount can be held together by screws, but I'm sorry, I didn't happen to have M2 DIN 965 6mm screws. But luckily these pieces could also be put together with some superglue.
It's okay, so I'm just gonna let it cure a little bit.
Now I can just screw the focus ring on the base, put in this actually fitting screw, which I harvested off of an old broken PS4 controller, so that I can't accidentally unscrew it. And now it's time to enjoy my creation.
Okay, the moment of truth. Ah, shit. Maybe I just need to rotate a bit. Nope, that just makes it worse. We can do some macro photography though. Yeah, let's do that.
The lens that I got from my disposable camera has a smaller focal length than the one Volzotan used, and so I would have to mount it closer to the sensor in order to be able to achieve infinite focus. Because of that, I started tinkering.
I was trying to mount the lens a bit further back so I could get a larger focus range, but for that I needed to glue it to the mount here, and the glue got on my hands and on the lens. And yeah, I think I can confidently say that this lens is ruined now.
Yep, I just destroyed my only lens. If I wanted to continue, I needed to get the glue off of the lens, and I tried normal soap, then I switched to strong dish soap, and then to isopropyl alcohol, but nothing worked, so it was time for some more drastic measures.
So after I had tried everything, I decided to say fuck it and put a butane torch to its head. It's completely demolished. And the awesome thing is, the scratches are still in there. It is phenomenal. What are these scratches made of? Are these not even scratches? I have no idea. Yeah, so now I have this piece of plastic with me. And so I could get a new lens, but instead I'm gonna try and make my own one. It actually kinda worked. Kinda. You see like the small point in the middle there? That's a lens. Yeah, now I'm gonna have to get a new one.
Luckily, turns out my parents had an old like cheap underwater camera in a random cupboard the entire time. I was able to break that one apart to get another lens. And imagine my surprise when I learned that this lens actually was just a more high quality version of the last lens with the same focal length of 28mm. Now I just needed to build the new casing, which means it was time to relearn fusion. I modified the design by Volzotan to fit my new lens. In order to be able to print the new lens body without support, I had to split the focus ring into three parts instead of the original two. Now one part is the focus ring, in it I can glue the aperture, and then the actual lens can be clamped in by a small ring. That way the lens is still pretty protected and it doesn't have to be glued in, which definitely makes me feel a bit more at ease. After my teacher again printed the parts for me, I assembled everything. And now the only thing left to do is to take this lens on a test drive. I'd say for my first 3D printed project, this actually went pretty smoothly. I'd count this as a win.